And I love Danny too much for me to see Danny get hurt. Or, you know, so I'm in there with him mentally. You know what I mean? So I'm fighting with him. That's the difference between me and Danny and a lot of other people.
Do you guys think a
lot? Well, we do a lot of things in common,
Okay.
Club together?
We, basically, we always together, like.
Yeah.
We always together.
Even clubbing, huh?
Yeah, we club too.
Are there any aspects? You notice he says he doesn't drink, but he doesn't
drink. I get it.
You do the party for him?
I get it enough to have fun. I don't get drunk stupid. Now.
So you're saying, how much fun
they gotta drag me home.
How much fun are you guys having right now? I mean, you were saying it's so unexpected, this success, that just jumped to this plateau. How much are you guys having taken time to just enjoy it?
Well, basically, we haven't enjoyed. Like, I want to enjoy it because every time we have a fight, then we got another one, like, 3 months later. So I haven't had a vacation, like, for, like, 2 years already, so.
Wow.
So after this, do you prefer him a little bit longer of a layoff before fighting?
Well, I think that's perfect. Every 3 months is good.
Yeah.
You want to keep a fighter active.
Yeah.
And, you know, and the thing is that you got to take advantage of destiny. That's what destiny is. You can't leave something for tomorrow. Tomorrow's not promised. So you got to do it at the advantage. That's what happens to a lot of people. They start saying back, wait. Look at an example, Floyd and Manny. All this.
Waited too long.
No, it's never going to happen. Yeah. No, it's never.
Now nobody cares.
Yeah, it has no value.
It's never. What's behind it now?
Yeah, they were at the peak of their power.
You know what I mean? Like, you know, you got to understand. Somebody tells you something, you do it right there in the moment. That's destiny. It's meant to be. When you start planning and choosing things in life, then the things don't work out the way you want it to work out.
That's very true.
How do you keep?
How well do you receive your stardom, man? Because I mean, you became like an entertainment as well. I mean, when you guys have a press conference, I got to tell you, I stop whatever I'm doing just to hear what you got to say.
Thank you.
You know.
Well, the thing is, I don't plan it, man. It's just natural. I mean, you got to understand. Anybody can sit there and tell you boring. Oh man, come on. Let's tell the truth.
Yeah.
Let's speak the truth. The truth is, I hate you. Like, you ready to fight my son? Like, no, I don't like you. Like, after the fight, when we whip your ass, then we go party.
Yeah.
You're painted. You're painted. You know what I mean? You're painted. I'm not painted. Nothing.
Angel,
I'll get a bit. Yeah.
Angel, how do you keep someone grounded? Like, especially a boxer who has to be conditioned, has to be in bed early, keep his friends, sponsors, money. How do you juggle all that?
It's hard, but you know, you gotta stay focused, man. You know, hey, listen, life, nothing's easy in life. You know, us men, it's nothing easy for us. We gotta work. We gotta from here to forehead. So you just gotta keep going, man. Listen, the days are too short, man. We live in a time right now, in an era where life ain't promised. So you gotta think. You're young right now. That's how you gotta think. And knowledge is free. It's gonna be a good listener. And knowledge is free. And you'll be successful in the future. You know what I mean? But listen, God didn't put us here to be easy. There's nothing easy in life. Nothing. So I just do it, listen, day by day. I get up at 6 in the morning every day. No alarm clock. My day ends at 9 o'clock at night every day. Every day. If I'm home, like just sitting around, I go crazy. I can't, I got to work.
Do you think that's what makes Danny so successful? Yeah, that he has a father like you that tells him the truth?
No, you're right. Yeah, because I never kept nothing from Danny. When he was younger, it was school, gym, and the house. He used to sit out the window, look at his friend. I used to tell him, listen, you see all your friends out there? Only one's going to make it, and that one's got to be you. I said, all them guys out there, half of them, I'm not trying to jinx nobody. I said, half of them will be drug addicts. Half of them will have girls pregnant. Half of them will be dead. Half of them are going to go to jail. And exactly that. All his friends are all in jail. They all got girls pregnant. They all drug addicts, half of them. And he made it. You know, I took a lot of his childhood. It wasn't easy for me to keep him in the house locked in. And I'm not proud of it. But I don't regret it today. Because I love him too much to see his life go to waste.
How proud are you of Danny?
Yeah,
so
I'm real happy for him, man. You don't understand how much I love him, man. I love him. Because I'm so happy. Not about boxing. It's not about the money. It's that he's a good son. And I wish all the kids in the world would be like Danny. I'm not saying you're a bad kid, nothing like that. But I'm saying, like, parents should be more involved with their children.
Out.
Exactly. You know what I mean? You got to be involved. Like, right now, them kids, they all died out there in Connecticut. Was it Connecticut?
Yes. Yeah.
You know what I mean? Look at that. Little kids, man. You know what I mean? Somebody gonna just assassinate little kids. Like, you know, then he killed his son. He's 20 years old. I mean, how bad life is at 20?
Yeah, seriously.
How bad is it? I used to eat, man. I'd wake up hungry. My stomach burning. A little kid didn't understand why my stomach was burning. I didn't have it easy. Everything I got, I earned it. I worked hard. Nobody ever knocked on my door and told me, your kids got no milk? No, I had to go out there and get the milk for my children. You know what I mean? Life ain't easy, man.
What was the biggest lesson life has taught you?
Man, listen, the biggest lesson life taught me is life is short. When I caught cancer, I had throat cancer. I was dying. I was stage 4. I was dying stage. They gave me 6 months to live. And my doctor asked me, you ready to fight? I said, I'm a fighter. He said, you sure you ready to fight? I said, I'm a fighter. Stood 2 years, he went through a feeding tube. Couldn't eat nothing. You know, it was a feeding tube, drinking in short. You know, in short?
That yeah, bottom, yeah, I had a broken that,
you know, shooting it through a tube.
Oh, man.
For 2 years. For 2 years, never gave up. Because I used to look at my daughter. My daughter was 5. I say, I seen friends of mine that had died in the past. They've gotten killed. And I seen their children left stranded. They don't want to end up at the end of the stick. Nobody took over. You know, family man, nobody. And they turned out to be, they were a good kid, turned out to be a bad kid because there was nobody.
To guide
and I look, yeah, and I looked at my daughter, I said, that's not going to happen to my children. I'm going to fight for this. I'm doing it for my children. And listen, you know what burns me up too? That you get all this cancer donation dollars and all that. And I never had one donation come to me and tell me, listen, we paying your mortgage this month. For a whole year straight. None of them can. All these dollars, where they go at?
Everything that I would get.
You know, you go to the store, donate a dollar to cancer. What is money for? I ain't never had nobody offer me no rent, pay my rent. And I was dying stages. They gave me 6 months to live. I was dying. Like, I would wake up in the morning, go to chemo, radiation, all that, dying.
How many rounds?
Ain't vicious. Huh?
How many rounds did you have to go through with chemo?
Chemo, I did all 30 days straight chemo and 30 days straight radiation. And they tortured me, they burned me. I'm talking about my pain was so vicious that I don't hope that's my worst enemy. For my worst enemy, I don't hope that. That's why when I see people, and I be saying to myself, only they knew. Like, life is, like, it can happen to anybody. It can happen to anybody. Like, I can't promise, man. That's why, you know, I try to teach Danny. You know what I mean? That, to stay focused and appreciate life and work hard. Because dreams come true in America, man. You could be 50 and your dreams come true. Listen, when you pray to God, God heard you the first time. But in God's years, in His time, it's 20 years of our time. You understand? Like, you do a prayer, you say, oh man, God never heard me. I've been praying for 20 years. You know, He heard you the first time. But in His time, in our years, it could be 20, and His time is 1 year. In God's time, 1 year.
You could have been a good minister.
Well, I should have. You know, I always wanted to do that.
Yeah?
Yeah, I always wanted to, not the preacher, I always wanted to be, like, you know, an inspiration, like help people, like talk. Yeah, exactly. Because, you know, I helped a lot of kids that they told me that, like, came and thanked me for that. Like, stuff that I had told them, and light went off. Because, you know, sometimes you can say things to people for 20 years, they never heard it. All of a sudden, he tells you, you heard it. But I've been telling you for 20 years, same thing he just told you. Because God worked through different people. That's how He works. He worked through different voices. That's when people say stuff, it wakes you up.
In terms of his development, are you now just gaining experience? That's the icing on the cake. Are there aspects to him that you still want to develop as a fighter?
Well, Danny, you got to understand, he been fighting since he was 10 years old, 8 years old. So what more experience he has? I mean, he's the WBA champion of the world, WBA. Now he's the champion. He's got to go out there and let people know that he's the true champion. Go out there and do, you know, do what he needs to do is go out there and destroy him in 4 rounds. He's got to destroy people in 4 rounds. Danny's young, strong. He punches with both hands. People got to understand it. He just doesn't have a hook. Danny has a right hand, too. And a two-hand fighter is a very dangerous fighter. Oh, yeah, he's got to go out there. He's number one. Yeah, he's got to go out there and be number one. There is no learning no more. There's nothing to learn. Let's go out there and do it. He's got to do his thing. He's got to go out there and prove to the world that he's number one and still undefeated champion of the world. February 9th, he's going to do it again with Zab. So I'm not underestimating Zab, but Zab's not doing nothing. It's a new era of fighters. And everybody gets their turn. It's like we all had our turn here. You know, we didn't take advantage of it. That's what we got to work now.
You had your choice of.
Or we only make an issue.
Well, the thing is, if I wanted Danny to fight somebody, it would be whoever's considered the best. It doesn't matter if it's Khan. It doesn't matter whoever. If you're the best and you're called the best, one day to fight the best. And if Khan deserves that shot, he gets the shot.